No.
Hello, how are you? I think that maybe you are kind of fine. I'm after three coffees, so if you're talking about me, I'm fine, at least now. And I've got two things to tell you, to show you. One thing is about what my foundation do, what Freedom and Entrepreneurship Foundation works on. And the second one will be a short speech. It won't be an actual lecture, more like a speech. So, well, this is our logo and our activities in this year. It won't be too much about history of what we've already done. I would like to stress on more current activities, what we are doing now, what we are doing and what we are working on. But of course, we always need some kind of history, and this is a short history of us. We were established 4 years ago here in Katowice. So we are kind of, well, we are playing on our own arena now. And this is our mission. We are concentrated for most of the times on promoting freedom, promoting entrepreneurship, of course. Well, this is our name. And we are not actual think tank. We are more like an educational think tank. We are concentrating on showing people the biggest possibilities, better possibilities from being more free, more entrepreneurs, and this is our job to do. We believe in division of labor and libertarian movement, and what we do is not politics. It's also not being real actual experts on some issues from public policy. No, we are doing something else. But I believe that there is enough space for us to do it. And what's important in our activity is that, well, I think that this is a little bit special if we're talking about global libertarian movement. We are a company. We are full-time libertarians. At least I am. I'm living only from being a libertarian. Foundation is my only way to pay my bills. But it's fine. It's really possible to live from being a libertarian and to live in a kind of good way, I think. So, if we are talking about our activities, those are current activities. So now we have four projects, a very big ones, that are now going on. First one, and for me, very, very important project, is Forgotten History of Krakow School of Economics. This is the project about making a movie about 1 hour long documentary. Well, that we show almost forgotten school of Polish economists from times before Second World War, or even times before First World War. Almost no one in nowadays Poland remember about such guy like Julian Dunajewski. But during his times, he was a first league statesman, and he was a first league economist. He was a savior of Austro-Hungarian treasury, really. And also, he was a teacher to Karl Menger, because Karl Menger actually knew Polish. And that's something great, right? But of course, no one knows about it. Probably most of you even didn't heard never about Julian Dunajewski. In Free Poland, nowadays Poland, the only pro tips about Julian Dunajewski's street called Dunajewski Street in Kraków. That's all. We want to change it. We want to show people that we Poles also have some free market heroes like Julian Dunajewski or like Adam Heidel, great patriot too, not only a great economist, who was attending a Mises seminars in Vienna. We want to show it. We want to show that we not always need to tell people the stories about Murray Rothbard or Ludwig von Mises. Of course, such stories are important. But hey, lots of Poles are very patriotic, right? We are more on right side if we're talking about societies than on the left side if we compare to other societies in Europe. So let's show them real patriots who also was for free market. This is the way of promoting freedom, in my opinion. Well, if you don't know this guy, you will know him. So that's all for now. This is one of the speakers, one of the experts who will talk in our documentary. So this is the first project. And here I'm making Austria great again, so this is nothing special. Of course, there will be some elements of docudrama during that movie. You will get actual actors who will play as Krzyżanowski or Heidel or Schumpeter, because Schumpeter was a very close friend to Adam Heidel. So it will be good for watching, I hope so. And of course, it's entirely privately funded. So thanks to Atlas Foundation, and thanks to our donors, we are able to make it. This is one of our most important things in our foundation. We're not taking money from governments, from European Union, or any kind of public money, only private money. And that's me here in episode about Swedish meat that we made in 2 months ago, I think, in Stockholm. That was 12th episode of our educational series, and also it was done only by private money. Well, what we wanted to show is that the situation about the Swedish welfare state is far more complicated than some statists believe it is, or some anti-statist believes it is. So some pro-capitalistic persons, peoples in Poland, also for most of the time, shows Sweden as kind of communist state. It doesn't work like that. Well, the only possibility to get such big welfare state is to have a very strong capitalism, because the capitalism is the only way to sustain such a waste of money, in my opinion. And thanks to Paweł Piwowar, that episode was done, because he made a tremendous job, tremendous work to do it. We were cooperating with Timbro, so this is a first league think tank from Sweden, from based in Stockholm. I think that is okay. This is the president of Timbro. You can of course see this episode on YouTube. And why I'm talking about this, yeah, I should be talking about current activities, but in my opinion, we are only in halfway with this project. Why? Of course, it's done, but you can help us in promoting it. So please, if you have blog, please write something about that. If you have some Facebook followers, please show it to them, because, well, making something is just a halfway. The next halfway is promoting that. And we need your help here. Next project, Project Arizona, it's not only about cheap wines here. Well, this is kind of a little internship for our pupils. I believe that we need some people that we should call, and we can call, officers in pro-liberty army, and we want to get them. We believe in trainings. We believe that if you give people a proper information, because we are rationalists, they will act in a better way. Maybe even if I am a little bit too romantic on that, I think that we, at least from time to time, can do it. This is our first really global project. We have people from Nepal, from Tajikistan, from Greece, Serbia, Mexico, Georgia, and 2 Poles, of course. And we want to send them for our trainings to Arizona. And after those trainings, they will be, well, better libertarian promoting persons. I think so. I hope so. This is the organization that we are cooperating with. I would like to stress your attention on Goldwater Institute and University of Arizona. In my opinion, those two logos are the most important ones. Honestly, I don't believe in political action, but some libertarians believe. So I hope that after visit of our friends, well, Arizona Libertarian Party will be even more professional than it is now. I hope so. And this is, of course, Arizona State University. We need to raise money. So if you want to help us, please do it. And the next our important project that is now is ongoing is Economical Starter Pack. Our idea is to provide to all schools in Poland some kind of economical starter pack that will be made by the, well, textbooks, DVDs, educational movies. We are working on our mobile app. We want to also make some conferences for teachers, that we want to show them that it is possible to use such a tools and how to do it. Of course, by the way, we will be promoting freedom and free market. So I think that this is win-win situation. They will get better materials, better tools, and we will also get something. And of course, it's crowdfunded, like always. And it's cheap, it's absolutely cheap. If you want to give such a starter pack to one school, you need only $10. That's nice, right? Thanks to Donald Trump, of course, because now dollar is, well, is skyrocketed. But I wouldn't vote for him if I was an American. So you can, of course, support us. We've got our page. Please do it. If you have a free spare 32 zloty, you can always make a difference. And this is Polish American Leadership Academy. Well, actually, the photo is from a little bit different event. But we always have some problems with good photos, so that's why we've used it. But the story is kind of similar. So one guy who's talking something about freedom to some students. So yeah, it works a little bit like that. This is our biggest project. This is something like our USS Lexington or something like a flagship. And we're using it to really to make a difference. We already made about 1,000 alumni during all those years. We have new courses about rhetorics. We have course for effective local politics. If you wanna join them, if you wanna join us, you can of course do it. We have some special discount, but if you want to talk about it, you need to do it with cooperator of our foundation, whose name is Paweł, and Paweł is he's a manager who works on that part of this course. Because yes, I don't believe in libertarian politics. I really don't believe on that. I believe in mind changing. After that, we will be able to get some really libertarian politicians. But there are some people who believe on opposite way. And this is not a problem for me. I'm not saying that I own the crystal ball and I know all the answers. Maybe I know none of them. So that's why, if you wanna be a pro-market and libertarian politics, in libertarian politics, you can do it. And maybe why not to start from your own city or from your own voivodeship? We can help you. Already in Poland, we have some pro-market guys in local governments. There will be our speakers. We've got vice president of Łódź, who's from Adam Smith Institute in Poland. We've got vice president of Sosnowiec, Krzysztof Hawadus, who's also a libertarian. So yeah, they can help you. They can show you how it works. If you believe in being in politics in local governments, you can join us. And well, this is not a mistake. I've made it blank because this is not our actions for now. This is the actions that we are doing now. But in the future, there will be more projects. I am sure that during this year, we will do next edition of Milton Friedman's summit during the vacation time. So that will be one thing. Maybe we will be able to do more episodes about our show, Freedom and about our show TV show. So we will see. This for now it's blank, but I hope that from year from now it will be with something. So. Thank you for your attention. This is our website. We are also on Facebook. You can give us like, that's always something. And that's all if we are talking about presentation. And now, I've got a short speech for you. I was asked for, well, I should start from the beginning. The question was, what topic should I choose? As a doctor of political philosophy, maybe I should choose something well more sophisticated, but I believe that such conferences are the most important thing about them is networking. So I would like to show you some kind of flourishings from such kind of thinking. It won't be very theoretical, but there will be some links to theory. And my topic is what means to be an intellectual entrepreneur or what means to be an entrepreneur of ideas. So, well, first thing that I believe that we can see when we are reading the topic is that, hey, what's up, right? What's up? Because, well, similarities to entrepreneurship and similarities to intellectuals or ideas in my opinion, are absolutely two different things. When I think about ideas, I think about colonnades from ancient Greek times, or about philosophers, about ongoing discussions, about universities, or about libraries. This is my connections with that topic. And when I'm thinking about entrepreneurship, they're absolutely different. Busy places, handshakes, business, steel mills, because I'm from Silesia, and places with stock exchanges, places when you can do money, make some money. So two different worlds, right? Well, at least it looks like on a first glance, but I believe that this is just a first glance. World of ideas, for most of the time, isn't very practical. If you know any professor of philosophy, you will know that he's not a very practical guy. Never. I've never met such a guy who would be a professor of philosophy, would be very practical, but maybe I just don't have enough friends that are titled so much that are professors. Most of intellectuals acts and works a little bit like guys from university in the Discord, I think so. And the second world is on the opposition, right? At least at the first glance, because it's very practical. It's practical. You need to do money. You need to get up early. There's no time for chatting. There's no time for long conversations. We need to do business because time is money. Two different things, but only at the first glance. Why? Because if you want to have properly working stock exchange, properly working steel mills, properly working business, and normal entrepreneurship, hey, you need proper ideas. It's impossible to do it without them. It's absolutely impossible. And ideas have the ability to change the world. It's working like that. So yes, there are some oppositions. It looks very, well, two worlds, right? But this is just one. Like a coin. You have one coin, but you have eagle from the one side, and from the other side, let's say that you have signed two zloty, or five. Hopefully that's five and two. So this is that thing. Well, if you want to do something with getting into better world, materially better world, with more goods, cheaper goods, better living, higher standard of living, you need to work on better ideas. You won't get there with such an ideas that are now, today, in the mainstream. It just will happen like in, let's say, Atlas Shrugged, one of the most important books I've ever read. In my opinion, this book is just like Deleuze, a very famous philosopher, said, this is a war machine. Such books are war machines, really. So you all need to read it. Please read it. If you didn't already done it, so maybe you know this book. What's very important is that even if we believe in some kind of ideas, and we believe that such ideas are the best ones, if we want to promote them, no one will know about it. No one, absolutely. And we will be lost. We will be lost, not because of our ideas who are weak, because they are not, but because of our promotion. Who can be weak. And unfortunately, for most of the time, even if we can win almost all academical battles, we cannot win almost none battles in our parliaments or with our friends, let's say. We cannot convince them. We can convince ourselves. This is, in my opinion, a big problem. What to do with it? By remembering that this is only one world, but you have two faces, we can establish a figure like a specialized worker who will be very swiftly moving from one side to other side. And that guy, I will call him an intellectual entrepreneur or an entrepreneur of ideas. Such a person won't be, never will be, as good in theories like a typical academical professor of philosophy or political science or economics. That's true, something for something, there's nothing for free. But he will be better in promoting such an ideas. He should work just like a businessman, just like a business person, because it can, of course, it can be also a woman. And if you are looking for some kind of patterns in the history about who was an intellectual entrepreneur, please check out Polish history, especially from 19th century. After losing everything during our very stupid uprisings, Poles started to think. People, for most of the time, start to think when they have nothing else to do. So they believed that our ancestors, if we cannot win with Russians or with Germans on the battlefield, maybe, just maybe, we can win with them on stock exchange, or maybe we can have a better organized society. And they started to do it. So in 19th century, we really had a lot of intellectual entrepreneurs. None of them was libertarian, because there were no libertarianism during those days. During those days, libertarianism was something like today's living on a squat, something like that. Well, real, actual libertarianism started from my grant, in my opinion, during 20s, 30s, something like that. But these people was really doing what they should do. So they were promoting the proper ideas, they were organizing people, and they were showing that if we can compete with other people, with other nations, we can also win with them, not only to compete. So there are some actual figures from in the past that was real actual entrepreneur, well, businessmen who was working with ideas. But intellectual entrepreneur isn't just a businessman or just an academic. He need to be able to move on one side and on the other side. And very important for having them is the fact that our enemies, our intellectual enemies, are already have them. And if they have them, we should have them too. I'm almost ending, so one of the last remarks will be my remark about division of labor in libertarian movement. In my opinion, one of the most important articles about how libertarian movement should work was written by Tom Palmer. I think that during 70s, I think so. And the topic is like that: the division of labor in libertarian movement. What's the story? What we need is not a professor of philosophy who will do everything, but he should be interested only in his job, in making proper ideas, and in intellectual battles with other professors who are opposing him. This is his job. If you are a student local group coordinator, coordinate that group. This is obvious. And if you are an entrepreneur, also entrepreneur of ideas, your group is to organize all of them, because the role of entrepreneurship in the world of ideas, in the world of promoting ideas, is absolutely the same as the role of entrepreneurs who works with, I don't know, giving people better cars or giving people better toothbrush or something like that. So this is the same, and we really need them. If you want to coordinate our actions, we really need intellectual entrepreneurs. And that's very important for me. And now I'm absolutely ending my short speech. And now I'm returning to the beginning. So the power of connections. A real intellectual entrepreneur should have lots of friends, especially if he's a libertarian. What we need to change in our movement is to change that many people believe that libertarianism is something about autism, right? Yeah, this is that long-haired guy who never talks to no one and he's only on Facebook. This is how people think about libertarianism, and I think that we can change it. Not only by cutting our hairs, because probably I won't do it, but just talking with other guys. If you're going to have more connections with other people, our businesses, like promoting ideas, we'll be on a better level. And we need to do it. We need to do it because we are not backed by someone else. We are probably that generation that can change it. If we won't do it, well, who will do it for us? Well, this is our job. We need to do it. And I think that's all. So please have a lot of fun during that conference. Remember that lectures are important, but far more important is everything that between lectures and after lectures. Please remember about that. And remember about one final thing. Ideas aren't like material goods. Well, if you can share idea, well, this is not a book from classical role play game called Fallout. It won't disappear if you will talk about ideas to other people. You just will share the idea. So sharing is caring, right? This is great. Remember about sharing ideas and try to understand this venue as a market, when you can maybe find some kind of new possibilities to sell your goods, which is ideas. Maybe you will be able to find some new contractors and work with them and do it all for you, but also do it for liberty. Thank you for